Hello there, Foxy friends. Welcome to our tutorial on how to first set up the Simply Schedule Appointments plugin. We want to show and explain everything going on as you go through our setup wizard. First, we're going to activate the Simply Schedule Appointments Free Basic Edition. We can do this right from the plugins page in the WordPress dashboard. I'm just going to search up the word Simply, and that should be enough to find this plugin. Just make sure to find Foxy in the icon. I also want to note that if you have a paid edition, please see our guide on how to install that. I'll leave the link in the description box below. After activating, you'll see that a new tab is created in the sidebar called Appointments. This is where you'll set up the booking calendars and manage your appointments. If this is your first time opening up the Appointments page, you'll be greeted by Miss Foxy and her handy dandy setup wizard. First, we'll set up general things like your time zone and your admin email. Foxy automatically tries to guess this stuff, but you can also change that using the Need Some Adjusting button. Next, we'll be walk through creating your first appointment type. An appointment type technically represents a single booking calendar. And so this is what will set up your availability and your booking form. This plugin doesn't limit the amount of calendars you can make, so if you wanted to get fancy with this, you could set up different appointment types for each of the services you provide. For example, if you're a freelance barber, you know that each service you offer takes different amounts of times, or if you only do, I don't know, buzz cuts on Tuesdays, then it makes a lot of sense to create separate calendars for each one, so that your customers can be clear on what they're signing up for. Since this plugin helps you avoid double bookings, by default, each appointment type is dependent on each other, meaning that if someone books your 9 a.m. slot in your haircut calendar, then that 9 a.m. slot is automatically blocked off in all your other calendars too. But that can be changed. I'll leave a guide for how to do that in the description box below. Now we're going to start off with the basic settings tab. This starts with the name of the booking calendar. This is visible to your clients, so don't name it Calendar 1. It needs to be descriptive, especially if you plan to create a bunch of appointment types. The duration represents the time slot length. This can span anywhere from a couple minutes to multiple weeks long. This colored label doesn't affect your customer-facing booking calendar. It's meant to help you organize. Again, if you have a list of 10 appointment types, it's helpful to color code for your own sake. We'll go through styling in a separate video. The booking view is how your customers will be able to look at the dates. The monthly view is best when you expect customers to book weeks in advance. For example, a very busy wedding photographer needs 1 month notice and probably doesn't want her customers to scroll through 5+ weeks to find a good date. Whereas a dog adoption center would prefer their customers to book within a week to visit a dog before someone else adopts them. Now, the instruction field appears at the top of the booking form and is meant for short comments. But if you needed to add more instruction, you can add a bit more detail to the notifications later. The capacity field is blocked out. This is included only in the paid editions. This is if you'd like simultaneous bookings for classes or reservations. If you're using paid editions, I'll also leave the guide for setting up the capacity down in the description box below. This first setting lets you choose between available blocks or specific start times. With available blocks, customers could book any time within the time span you choose. With specific start times, you get to choose exactly when your appointments can start. This is useful if you're running tours or classes. You need the class to start, for example, at 4 p.m., not just anywhere between 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. The time slot intervals setting lets you choose the start times for the calendar. This will also affect the number of time slots your booking calendar will display. For example, a 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. availability could be drastically changed from displaying only 8 time slots with 60-minute intervals to displaying 48 time slots with 10-minute intervals. the availability table will now let you choose your preferred time to take bookings. This view has a pencil and eraser tool to help you choose times with the available block setting. And with the specific start time setting, you can select an entire row, just choosing the time on the left side column. You can also use the plus signs to extend the hours here. The availability table helps you select the times that you're willing to take appointments. This plugin doesn't give you the option to approve or deny bookings, so if someone books, it's automatically confirmed. Let's continue to the scheduling options. Starting with the time zone option, here you get two choices. Use the lock setting when your appointments take place in a certain geographical area. This makes sense if your customers tend to live in the same area as you, like the barbershop or dog adoption center examples. Use the localized option when the appointments take place online or through the phone. This is best when you have customers all over the world. It auto-detects the customer's time zone, but also gives them the option to change it. This would be a great option if you're an online consulting business and tend to have customers from all over the country. The appointment buffers help set up some space between booking. This is to guarantee that you'll always have some time to prep or wrap up after each appointment. The notice required setting limits how late a customer can book a time slot. It's meant to help avoid last-minute bookings. Lastly, the per-day limit, as you guessed, will limit the total number of bookings in a day for the single booking calendar. Once the limit is reached, all the time slots on that particular day disappear automatically. As a side note, these are the core rules for scheduling that you can set. We do offer more rules you can enable later called the advanced scheduling options. I'll leave a guide for that in the description box below. Moving on, we get to the customer information tab. This lets you choose what gets included in the booking form before someone can book their appointment. The name and email are always required. We need those fields for the plugin to properly function. All the paid editions do include the custom field feature. That'll let you spice up your booking form. It lets you create other fields like checkboxes and radio buttons. But if you want to take this to the next level, we also have integrations with Formidable Forms and Gravity Forms. I'll leave those guides in the description box below too. Now, as a last step, you'll get a quick overview of the booking calendar you just set up. You can also go back and edit any of the previous tabs if something doesn't look right. And here, in the booking info section, you'll see a note telling you that you'll need to take the short code and paste it into a website page of your choosing. This top short code will list out all the appointment types you have, and this bottom one will only display the specific appointment type. Finally, you'll see a cute little congratulations screen with Foxy letting you know she's going to take care of you from now on. Consider her your new booking secretary. From this page, you can test out your booking calendar using the admin booking page, or go to the Simply Schedule Appointments settings, where you can play around with the advanced scheduling options, notifications, or style your calendar. The other button option here takes you to create a new appointment. You can also just exit to the WordPress dashboard using this arrow in the top left corner to go on to displaying your booking calendar on your site. Whatever you choose to do, just know that we have a help center to help you finish setting up. Please find the link for that below. Thanks for watching, Foxy friends.